The Red Sox have never been known as a team for their speed and defense. But this season, those two ingredients may just be the key to the Red Sox having a championship-type season. So as we look at the Boston Red Sox and the makeover that they had coming into 2013, obviously the biggest thing that's happened for the Red Sox this year has been their pitching staff. They've pitched outstanding so far, and it is definitely the biggest reason why they've been successful. But there's something else going on at Fenway Park that I noticed, and that is speed and defense on this team. You know, a lot of times in baseball, people say speed kills. And the Red Sox now have plenty of it, with Jacoby Ellsbury and Shane Victorino at the top of that lineup, and Pedro Siriaco, who can run, and when he was here early in the season, Jose Iglesias, who can run and bunt. The Red Sox have been just an outstanding team so far in terms of speed and defense. And I'll tell you something. As I watch these games, there's such a comfort level now when I see balls hit into the outfield, knowing that Ellsbury and Victorino are out there and can cover a lot of ground in that outfield. I feel such a big comfort level when I see balls hit out there that those plays are going to be made. And for the most part so far, those guys have made 95% of the plays, and they've saved the pitching staff a lot of runs. And that's how you win ball games, not just with your pitching, but with your defense. And again, the Red Sox have never been known as a defensive juggernaut. At times they've had very good pitching staffs, but never has their defense, I think, really been as good as it has a chance to be this year. Even without Iglesias at shortstop, Stephen Drew has shown that he's more than capable as a defensive shortstop. And if he hits, of course, that's going to be an even bigger bonus. But I just find myself feeling a way about this Red Sox team that I have not felt about them in many, many years. And that's that when that ball is put into play, the play will be made, the pitcher will get the out, and the inning will not be extended because of an error or bad player or otherwise. And then on offense, when you have speed, you can steal bases, you can advance that extra base on a single to the outfield, it produces more runs. So what we're seeing so far with this Red Sox team is very different than things that we've seen in the past historically with this team. This team has really been about on-base percentage and the three-run homer. And you do have that occasionally. But with David Ortiz being out for the early part of the season, the Red Sox have had to play baseball a little bit differently. Now, when John Farrell came over from Toronto, there was talk about he would emphasize the running game, that stolen bases would be important to the Red Sox. Well, he didn't have much success with that in Toronto, but I don't think he really had the right kind of speed players there. Ellsbury and Victorino are smart base runners. They know when to steal bases. There was concern in spring training that Ellsbury had no stolen bases, but he's got six or more right now. That leads the team, so he's fine as far as stolen bases go. He's a smart base runner, as is Victorino. And when you have smart base runners, it produces more runs off the base paths, you get more victories, and you get more wins. So for you guys out there, as you look at this Red Sox team, are they really a very different team than what you've seen in the past 5 to 10 years? Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and tell all your friends about This Week in Red. And don't forget to check out my blog at BosoxInjection.com.